Hey everyone, this is Viren and welcome back to my YouTube channel for another marketing tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create video remarketing ads for those users who've already seen your videos on YouTube. This is pretty straightforward, very, very simple. I have created a video ad for them. I'll show you the ad first. So in this video, you will see that I spend the first 5 seconds really connecting with the audience, so it doesn't look like a regular ad that you see in TV and you skip in 5 seconds. So in the first 5 seconds, I tell them that you have seen one of my videos, and then I give them a very short introduction and I finish off the ad. Here it goes.
Wait a second, I know you. You were on my YouTube channel looking at some marketing tutorials but did not hit the subscribe button. Well, I'm here to convince you once again. Check out my channel. It's got marketing tutorials from Facebook, AdWords, LinkedIn, Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, and all of that. And I put up a new video every week. Every week, one video to teach you something new. Please hit the subscribe button this time.
There you go. Very short and simple. We're going to use this video to create a remarketing ad. So let's jump right into Google AdWords. Once you're here, you'll first need a remarketing list, which you create under Tools, Audience Manager. I already have a remarketing list, so I'm not going to show you how to create one, but there's a link to one of my videos right here. It will show you how to create remarketing lists on YouTube. You can see that once you're done with this tutorial, but pretty much you will need this remarketing list. So what I have created is, I'll quickly show you. Someone who's viewed any video from my channel, and the membership is open for just 30 days. So if someone's not watched a video on my channel for 30 days, they automatically leave this audience. We can use this in search ads, YouTube ads, display ads, and Gmail. For this particular tutorial, I'm using this on YouTube ads. Let's go back into the ads manager, go to campaigns, and create a new campaign. You can choose any of the goals, and when you hover over it, you'll see what goal supports video. So I'm going to choose product and brand consideration, video ads. You can give your campaign a subtype, which is basically standard consideration, means driving views, engagements, and consideration, or shopping if you are trying to sell something. I'm not trying to sell something here, so I'm going to stick to standard consideration. Click on continue. Once you're in, give your campaign a name. Give your campaign a budget. You can choose from a daily or a total budget. So let me give this a daily budget of like 500 rupees. You can choose between standard or accelerated delivery. As you know, the difference is that standard delivery tries to spread your budget throughout the day, and accelerated will try and spend your budget as soon as possible. So you can select start and end date. So I'll start as soon as possible and not have an end date. You can select where you want to show the ad, YouTube search results. Not for this one, I want that to be a skippable ad because my content is created that way, and I don't want to show my ads on the video partners on display network as well. So I want my ads to be shown only on YouTube. Languages. So I'll select English as the language since my ad is made in English. Now as you make these selections, you'll see that the available impressions on YouTube will start filtering here. Right now it's 10 billion plus, so we'll really need to narrow this down. Location, not necessarily India. I'm going to stick to all countries and territories because this is a remarketing ad and I get viewers from across the world. Bidding strategy, cost per view. That's the only option we have in this campaign. So I'm going to stick to cost per view. Inventory type. So there are three kinds of inventories that YouTube provides you. The expanded inventory will basically try and exclude extreme content like profanity, sexual content, violence, things like that. The standard inventory will exclude all of this, and it also excludes some other things like violence, either real or dramatized, sexual content again, things like that. And limited inventory basically means that you will remove all of this, and even moderate profanity or sexual suggestive content, your ads will not show up on those kind of videos. So I'll stick to limited inventory. Let's close this. Excluded content. Now basically, is there any kind of content you want to exclude your ad from? Sensitive social issues, tragedy kind of videos. You can choose any of these you want. exclude type and labels. So based on the labels of the video that the user is watching, you can choose to not show your video there. And you can also exclude certain content types like embedded videos, live streaming, games. I'll leave this on. There are some additional settings where you can choose if you only want to show your ads on mobile devices or all eligible devices. You can cap the frequency so that one person sees your ad only, say, 2 times a day at a campaign level. And you can also obviously add schedule if you want your ad to run only certain time during the day. Next up, we'll create an ad group and let's give this a name. We need to select a maximum cost per view. I'm going to select 50 paise. Now let's get into demography. You can exclude or include gender, age, parental status, or household income. I like to keep all of this intact because I'm creating a remarketing list. So basically, if someone's already seen my video, I just want to show them an ad. Under audiences, you can get into detailed demography and get into things like education, home ownership status. You can also look at their interests or habits. You can also target based on what they are researching or planning currently on Google. This is extremely powerful. I'll use it in another tutorial. But what we are looking for here is that they've already interacted with your business remarketing list. So I'm going to choose my YouTube remarketing list. And finally, content. What kind of content do you want your ad to show up on? You can add keywords if you want. Basically, YouTube will match these keywords to the content that your ad is displayed on. I do not want to filter that. You can also choose the kind of topics that your ad should show on. So basically, if I select something like business and industrial, then all the videos categorized as business and industrial, my ads would only show up on those videos. And finally, placements. If you have particular YouTube channel or YouTube videos, apps where you want your ad to show, you can select this here. I don't want to filter on any of that. And finally, we reach the step of creating the ad. So you will first have to add a link to the video you want to promote. This doesn't have to be a live video. It could be an unlisted one as well, like my video right here. But you cannot use a private video. I'll just paste the link here. There are these two kinds of ad format that I can select from: in-stream ad, which is basically the skippable ad that we all know. And the other is video discovery ad, where you show up at the bottom of a video playing and the user will actually have to click on the ad to see it. I'm going to select in-stream ad. You will need to add a URL and a display URL as well. And finally, the companion banner. Now, a lot of times you'll see that while watching an ad, there are banners that come alongside on the right hand side while you're watching the ad, which is of the same brand that is showing you the ad. So if you want to customize that, you can upload images and choose the banner here. The next option is to just leave it at auto generate, where YouTube will sort of pick videos from your channel and populate them here. I'll just leave it at auto generate. Now give your ad a name. Just give it add one, save and continue. That's it. The campaign is ready. Continue to campaign. I can see the ad group I created right here. And when you click on it, you can see the ad as well. So I've been running this ad for a while now. I'll get into some of the statistics for you. These are some of the ads that I had created with that video. And then you can look at some of the stats for this video. As you can see, I've gotten about 3.7k impressions, views. The view rate is 52%, which basically means that 52% people end up watching 30 seconds of your video. And if your video is less than 30 seconds, which for me is the case, 24 seconds, this means that they watched your complete video. And cost per view, the total cost and things like that. Well, that's about it for this tutorial. I am now open to video suggestions. If there is a particular tutorial you want me to make for you, just leave them in the comments below and I will definitely get back to you and make that video. In fact, this video has also been made for one user who had commented in one of my videos and asked for this tutorial. So this video is for him. All right. Thank thank you guys. Subscribe to my channel for more videos like this.